First, I would like you to get into a comfortable position. Close your eyes and concentrate on your breathing. This is a time for you to relax. There is no right way or wrong way to do this exercise. There is only your way. So don't worry about how you are doing it. Just do it your own way. That's fine. God knows exactly what you need to experience. As you concentrate on your breathing, the rhythm of your breathing, the cool air coming in and the warm air going out, you begin to feel more relaxed and at peace. Your arms and legs begin to feel heavier and warmer. You are beginning to relax at your own rate, at your own pace. You can trust yourself. You are in the safety of your own mind. As you concentrate on your breathing, see, as completely as you can, ocean waves. See these waves in an image inside of your mind. See these waves build as you inhale and wash upon a shore as you exhale. The waves are relaxing and peaceful. They build and wash upon the shore. They build and wash upon the shore of an island. This is your island where you are totally alone. There is no one here but you. There is a large white sandy beach and palm tree groves. You are standing on the beach, looking out at the waves as they build and wash upon the shore. It is a warm day and you can feel the warm sunshine on your cheeks and on your arms. There is a trail on this island. Now you turn and see yourself take that trail. You are not in a hurry. You have plenty of time. You are walking very slowly, enjoying yourself. You feel more and more at peace with each passing breath. You walk up the trail under the palm trees. You look up and see the palm tree leaves gently twist and turn in a light breeze that you can now feel slightly in your hair. Up ahead on the right, there is a large rock. You come up to this rock and reach out and touch it. It is cool to the touch. There are little rivulets of water running down the rock. It is covered with moss. There are wildflowers along the trail, and occasionally you stop and look at the flowers more closely. You may even kneel down and smell the flowers. See yourself continue up the trail. And as you do, you come to a hill that winds upward and upward and upward. As you climb the hill, you become tired. Your arms and legs begin to feel heavy. You wind higher and higher and higher on the hill until you come to a ridge that overlooks a lush green valley filled with waterfalls. This is the Valley of the Holy Spirit. And you cannot come into this valley unless you ask. So inside of your mind, ask the Holy Spirit if you can come into this valley. The Holy Spirit says yes. All who ask may come into this valley. All who seek will find. All who knock will have this door opened for them. So you tip over the ridge and walk down into the valley. It is lush and green and smells sweet. The air seems cleaner and purer. It feels cooler coming through your nose. There is a crystal clear stream running alongside of the trail, running over rocks. It is beautiful here. You feel more and more at peace. You come to a tall waterfall with a rainbow in the mist. You stand there and watch the water and the rainbow, and then move on up the trail. You come to a hill that is covered with wildflowers, and you begin to climb that hill higher and higher. You can feel the wildflowers brush up against your legs as you climb. You feel a powerful pull up this hill, a very powerful pull. You do not understand it, but it is there. You feel a pull to God. You climb upward, higher and higher on the hill, where you can see all the way down to the sea and the forest below. The top of the hill is a huge field covered with wildflowers, and in the center of that field an altar. You feel a very powerful draw as you walk up to the altar. There is a oak pew, and you sit down in the pew, and you call out for your higher power three times. You may call out for God, Jesus, Creator, Holy Spirit. You call out for the higher power of your choice, but call out three times. Out of the trees down below walks a person dressed in white. He is walking right for you. The look on his face is so loving that your heart melts. You know who this person is. You have known this person all of your life. And as he comes closer to you, you stand up and instinctively open your arms and embrace this person. Somehow you enter into and become a part of this person. You now turn and look at yourself because you are still seated in the pew. But now you look at yourself through the eyes of God. You see yourself perfectly. Your whole life flashes before your eyes very quickly, yet very completely. You do not miss anything. You see all of the good things you have ever done, and you see all of the bad things you have done. From inside of God, you come to understand just how completely God loves you and how completely God forgives you. And you say, God, I'm sorry I have not loved you the way that I could have. I am sorry I have not loved others the way that I could have. I am sorry I have not loved myself the way that I could have. Now God shines his pure light of love into you, into every dark corner and recess of your mind and your body and your spirit. God cleanses everything until piece by piece, sin by sin, you are cleansed and purified. You are made God's perfect child again. God's masterpiece, God's perfect creation. You exit God, and God takes you by the right hand, and God walks you outside into the field of wildflowers underneath the warm sun. You sit down and cross your legs, and God sits down across from you and crosses God's legs. God reaches out and takes your hand and looks you right in the eyes. And God has a communication for you. Open up every means of communication you have, every sense, and receive the communication from God. I will give you 5 minutes, and I will count off the minutes for you. Ready? Begin. Thank you. That's 1 minute. You have 4 more minutes. That's 2 minutes. You have 3 more minutes. If you are receiving nothing but silence, stretch yourself into the silence. Any thinking or images that come to mind, any feelings that are coming to mind are from God. That's 3 minutes. You have 2 more minutes. You may have a question or questions for God. Ask the question or questions and God will answer you. That's 4 minutes. You have 1 more minute. Enjoy the presence of God. Soak it in. Feel the power and the glory of His presence. Feel how much God loves you. Know it. Thank you. Now you will seal in this communication from God. You will never forget it. God stands up in the field of wildflowers and you stand up. God cups your cheeks in God's hands. God looks you right in the eyes and says, I will never leave you. I am always here for you. All you have to do is ask, and I will come. Then God comes inside of your body, inside of your mind, inside of your spirit, where a part of God is going to stay. You are the temple of God. You walk down the hill, past the waterfall, up past the stream, out of the valley, down the hill, past the large rock, down to the sea, and back to the waves that are building and washing upon the shore. You feel yourself becoming more awake, gradually, peacefully. You feel happy, comfortable, and at peace. You begin to awaken, and when you feel comfortable, go ahead and open your eyes and become fully awake.